Afternoon, everybody.
It's Dan Zoller and Matt Brown from Filter Systems.
Good afternoon, everybody.
We'll be introducing our new product here. We've got the HFS BC. Our agenda today is we're going to go over the handheld filter units that we have in our HFS product family. We've got the HFS BC, which is the new model we'll be introducing today. And then we have our HFS, which has been existing for a couple of years now. And then we'll also review our filter cards and portable filter systems, show you how they line up. And then we'll also provide a marketing update for filter systems. So our HFS, we did a market assessment on it. And what we've done is we've designed a new handheld HFS to compete against the spin-on competitors. Designed this to provide equal or better filtration at a competitive price, using the GH filter elements with our Z-Media package. The applications for this unit's gonna be a lot of mobile equipment, generally any type of equipment that has some sort of small reservoir, can be used in plant for short-term offline filtration, roll-off cleanliness on smaller systems, and also for fluid transfer of delivery containers into the system. Specifications for the HFS BC, it's 4 GPM flow rate and maximum viscosity of 1600 SUS. Bypass setting on the elements is 25 PSI. And unit end seals on the pump and elements. And it is a quarter horsepower, 115 volt, 60 hertz motor.
Now, Matt, for the unit end type seals, what kind of material or fluids can you working with, and are we expanding in other type of seal materials as well?
Currently right now the GH is only offered in Puna, which will make it compatible with standard petroleum based fluids. Anything that requires Viton phosphated, such as a phosphate ester or a diesel, we do not have that capability at this time. Some of the features, we can make this unit with either a single or dual housings, which will offer true stage filtration. Elements available are 3, 5, 10, and 25 micron. And we also have water removal elements available as well. High beta ratio of 1,000, and our GH filters can hold 49 grams of dirt on a 9-inch housing with a 10 micron element. Another feature is the small footprint of this unit. It's roughly a little over a foot and a half wide on it. It incorporates its own carrying handle on the top, has true stage filtration. Inlet and outlet wands are provided. We provide 7-foot hoses with 1-inch wands. And we also have QDs on the hose connection to the unit, so you don't need tools to remove the hose. Some of the characteristics on the GH housing. The cartridge style elements are less expensive than the spin-ons, and they're environmentally friendly because you're only throwing away the element and not the outer housing. Operations without the element is not possible. We provide a secure aftermarket sales for the guaranteed Schroeder quality. And the integral bypass valve and head-to-bolt seal is incorporated on the element, so each time you change the element, it's going to be renewed.
Now specifically, you are mentioning that operation without an element is not possible. How is this done, and how would an operator see that there's no element in it?
It would be very evident in that case, as you see from the element right here. If you try and operate this without the element, you're going to get some leakage, and you'll know right away. As you can see in this picture right here, we have the integrated seal is actually built into the element. Bypass valve is built into the element as well. And right here you'll see the operation of it internally. So in your case, if you don't have an element, it's going to leak out of the side. It could cause some problem. Right. Now we can go through, you know, some of the competitors we have here that we've tried their elements. Cartridge competitor P or spin-on competitor D. And you can see the Schroeder element on the bottom right-hand side. It's got much lower differential pressure at the beginning and ending. And it also has a higher dirt holding capacity compared to our competitors. So we're offering much better quality.
You mentioned earlier that the cracking pressure is 25 psi, so when it starts going into bypass, how would this look like into this graph here specifically? What point would that be?
Well, it's going to be over about 1.7 bars. So if you follow that all the way over, you're going to get over 45 grams of dirt holding capacity before you start cracking.
Okay. And then obviously you might use it a little longer, so it builds up a little more dirt than the end of the original measure.
Correct. So with our HFS, we're going to be giving you a longer filter lifetime, 25% more dirt holding capacity. Patented quality protection. We're going to guarantee that our elements are going to be in there through the life of this machine. We're going to renew the bypass valve and O-ring seal at every element change. And you're going to have the small leakage if they're not using our elements. Some of the benefits also is it's going to have a lower operating cost. Our cartridge design is more cost effective than the spin-ons. We have a reusable bowl, which we're going to be minimizing on landfill waste, higher dirt holding capacity, and of course we're going to have a lower energy cost because of lower pressure differential. We're also going to offer this in a backpack mode, which is actually not that bad. The overall weight of the unit is about 39 pounds, and it provides a more convenient way of carrying the unit over long distances. It also incorporates its own drip drain there as well.
I can see here you have one filter placed on the backpack. Any plans of having a dual stage?
Not at this time, because if you look closely at it, you'll see the filter and pump motor group are on the same side.
Oh, yeah.
And on our other unit, the pump is actually on the other side with the two housings, yeah. So there's not enough space.
Otherwise, it will get too wide.
Yep. So. Here are your dimensions. You can see it's 15 inches by 13, you know, about 2 feet tall, including the handle. So right now we're only offering this with a 120 single phase 60 hertz motor at this time. You can purchase it with single or dual housings, the elements of your choice, uniseals, and the other really only option that you would have would be with the backpack. We still have the original HFS available, and this is going to be even a smaller, lighter package. It's only 28 pounds. You can get this one as well in a high or low viscosity and with a TCM. The standard viscosity is up to 1600. With the high viscosity unit, you can get up to 4600 SUS. It comes with two different flow rates, 4 gallons is standard, 2.5 with the TCM option, and we have three drive choices, standard 115, 24 volts, one pneumatic.
And since we have a little family here now of HFSs, can you maybe explain a little bit about the list prices for the different options here?
Yeah.
Versions?
A single HFS BC is going to list at $1,300. Dual cartridges is going to be about $1,425. And the backpack is going to be right under $1,500. Whereas our HFS is going to be $1,700, and then if you really wanted to load it up with options such as the TCM on there, you're going to be close to $6,500.
And then about lead times, especially for the HFS BC, the new one?
New one right now, we can pretty much get it out the door to you in 3 or 4 weeks. We have all the components in the house.
Okay.
So we'll go over an overview of our filter carts and how the portable units fit into our product lineup. On the lower flow ranges, we've got the HFS and HFS BC from 2.5 to 4. Next step up would be our 7 MFD MFS. Then our basic cart, which is at 10 GPM. And then we also have the 14 GPM model MFS MFDs. Below that are higher viscosity units. The high viscosity at 15,000 SUS is 3 GPM, and then we go up to the medium viscosity unit, which is up to 5,000 SUS, and that will be at 6 or 10 GPM. And then we have our smart carts with conditioning monitoring, AMFS at 5 GPM, and our filtration station, which is available on two different flow rates, fixed 9 gallon per minute or variable 3 to 8. So we can cover a wide range with our product line of reservoir sizes. Some of the marketing that we have now, we're going to be updating our online version for our filter systems catalog. That's just about done. We should have that ready at the end of the month. And our marketing gentleman across the way will gladly publish that for us.
And in general, the online version is always up to date. So if you
Correct.
Need some information, just go there, download the filter catalog. It's always the latest one.
Correct. Our printed catalog, we do that on a biannual or semi-annual basis, every 2 years. So it tends to get out of date quickly. So please use our online version. It's the most up to date that we have. We've updated also our application brochures. We now have the new contamination control sensors, filter carts, kidney loops, and dehydrators. And these are available online for you to print out.
They are a very good starting point. If you have a new customer, for instance, you can basically start talking about the need and what we have to offer.
Correct.
That just gives a glimpse and explains why it is important for monitoring and for fluid conditioning.
And it gives us a nice starting point on what products that we have to offer. And then please go to our website. We're going to be doing a full implementation and update of that in the next couple of months, and that'll be fully up to date and fully operational. So that would be the first place to go for the information, and then you can call myself, James Campbell, or Dan Fuller to assist you.
Next month we are doing another webcast for filter systems, and that will have we planned for next month.
I think what we'll do is we'll review the Triton A, some of the updates we performed to it, and we can also add in some of the application specific and some of the return on investments that we've been able to provide some of the end users.
So more application coverage next month.
Yeah.
Okay,
more
looking forward to that application. Not in that case.
Okay, we'll sign off here. Thanks for your time, guys.
Thank you. Bye-bye.